Hi everyone, my name's Sheila Kanani and today I'm going to take you from Earth to Saturn on board the Cassini spacecraft, and we're going to be looking at Saturn and a couple of Saturn's moons as well. So the Cassini spacecraft is a NASA and ESA joint mission. It was built in the late 1990s. It cost about $5 billion, so it was really expensive. But the information that it's been giving back about the Saturn system has been so incredible that it's been worth every penny. This is a time-lapse movie of Cassini being built in NASA's JPL. And as you see Cassini in its entirety, you can see it's one of the biggest ventures NASA has ever done. Here's a person here for scale. And it's actually about as big as an American school bus. The huge dish on the top of Cassini there sends the information back home, just like a satellite TV on the roof of your house. And this big gold thing here is the Huygens probe. Now, the Huygens probe actually landed on Saturn's moon Titan and gave us information for about 18 months. Cassini's really interesting. It's got 12 instruments on board, and these instruments all do different things. There's a dust analyzer, there's cameras, there's infrared cameras, there's a magnetic field data analyzer, and there's a Cassini plasma spectrometer. The Cassini plasma spectrometer is really important to me because my lab, Mallard Space Science Laboratory, which is the Space and Climate Physics Department of UCL, actually built part of the Cassini plasma spectrometer, and that's about here on this screen. Now, we built the electron spectrometer that's there in a vacuum chamber in the lab, and if you rotate it by 90 degrees and cut it in half, this is a schematic of the electron spectrometer. The electrons fly in here and they're detected by panels down here. Now, with the electron spectrometer and all the other instruments on board Cassini, we can find out so much more about Saturn, its rings and its moons, and the whole Saturn environment. This is one of my favourite pictures from Saturn, and you might think it's kind of boring because the planet itself is in shadow, and that's because the Sun is behind the planet, so the face of it's all black, but that's really cool because it's actually lighting up the rings, and you can just about see the largest ring, the E-ring, here, and you can see how far out the rings actually extend from the planet. Now, if you zoom in on the top right-hand corner, you can see the rings here again and here. You can see this tiny little blue dot, and it looks pretty insignificant, but if we zoom in on it there, that is what the Earth looks like from Saturn. So it's a pretty humbling experience seeing our planet from someone else's perspective. Let's look at the moons now. Titan, Saturn's biggest moon. It's bigger than Mercury, bigger than the planet Mercury, and it's got its own atmosphere. It's obscured in these thick orange clouds, but if we look at it in different instruments, visible light and infrared, we can actually learn a lot more about Titan itself. Titan has got liquid lakes on it. Not liquid water, unfortunately, but liquid methane. And this sounds a bit strange, but it's very interesting because the Earth is thought to have had liquid methane lakes on it about 5 billion years ago. So if we could go back to Titan in 5 billion years' time, who knows, maybe there would be life. Another really interesting moon is Saturn's moon Enceladus. It's about 500 kilometres wide, so about the size of the UK, and it's actually covered in a water ice crust. This picture was taken from a flyby, only 50 kilometres from the moon's surface, and you can see these huge structures in the water ice. Now, one of the reasons I like Enceladus is because it was named after the Greek gigante Enceladus, and he was actually killed by the goddess Athena. He was buried underneath the island of Sicily, and it's thought that when he gets angry and shakes, he shakes the whole island, and the people on the island believe that that is when Mount Etna is going to erupt. The reason I like that is because if we look at a photograph of Enceladus the moon, you can see these huge cracks, and they're not volcanoes, but they are cracks in the water ice. And when they rub together, the moon actually lets off liquid water into the Saturn system. This incredible photograph here shows the water plume of Enceladus letting go liquid water into the Saturn system. This is really cool because one of the models of this water ice being let off into the Saturn system involves a saline ocean underneath the ice crust. A saltwater ocean is really exciting because that could mean plants or maybe even life underneath the surface of Enceladus.